So we wanted to start giving you a few more like human updates, and let's start with March. Although we're cheating a little bit because this is not just what we did in March. It's something that we have been working on for the last few months. Anyway, let's start with the list. It's a long list, so let's try to go quickly. In the past 13 weeks, the team has been working on more or less 20 substantial improvements on Evernote. Some of these I'm going to be covering today, not all of them because there are many. So here are the most important ones. First of all, in January and February, we've released the new Evernote UI on desktop, which features both an improved note editor with a new font, new spacing, and new little like aesthetic details, which are nice. As well as an improved navigation and like an improved UI all around the product. The feedback that we've received was amazing, so we're really proud of this. And of course, there were some hiccups in the beginning, but we're able to improve it, fortunately, and we fixed like the little contrast items, especially that some of you were commenting on, and I think those were all great points. And so we've quickly released some updates on that. Next, Microsoft Outlook Calendar integration. Now, this is something that people have been requesting for a long time, and I'm happy that we were finally able to build it. Of course, as you can imagine, what this does is you have an Outlook Calendar account, and you can just now connect it to your Evernote account and use the Evernote Calendar feature together with your existing Outlook events. Next is Evernote Calendar. This is what I was mentioning. So there is a new section on desktop that is called Calendar, in new section in your sidebar that is called Calendar. And you can see it's like very handy to use because it's a full screen section instead of only a widget in the home as it was previously. And you can see full screen your calendar for the day. And if you're in the context of editing a note, you can just click the little eye icon there. And it opens the pop-out window. Next is AI Edit. So this is one of the few AI features we've been building together with AI Note Cleanup and AI Search. AI Edit is an extension of AI Note Cleanup, and it allows you to select some text, choose like one of those actions that you see there, like summarize, fix typos, help me write or translate. And then there are further options that you can choose, but basically the concept is you select some text and you let AI process it. Next is collapsible sections. This was also a very vocally requested feature that we've been hearing for a while. I use it all the time personally, and I know that a lot of people use it all the time. Basically, near every heading or every list item, you now see a little toggle. If you click that toggle on desktop, it will collapse the whole section under that heading or that list item. Next is slash command. This is also something that a lot of people were requesting for a long time. Again, super easy to understand. You just hit slash in a new line in a note from desktop, and you just see this menu of items that you might consider adding. This means that you never have to leave your keyboard as you're typing. The new button, the new button in a sense. Earlier you needed to click twice to create a new note, a new task, a new whatever. Now if you want to create a new note or a new task, you just need to click one button. So this is a very quality of life improvement, but like everything we all do on Evernote is creating new stuff basically all the time, and now it takes one click instead of two. So now this was March and February and a little bit of January. Now you might be wondering, what is next? Some of these things we've already talked about somewhere if you've been following us. The main thing that we're working on is a new mobile home. This is not the final version. So every time we're going to be talking about what's coming soon, this is not going to be a final presentation of what's coming. More like this is the state of our reasoning. So currently we are considering releasing a mobile home that works in one of these two ways. So either the number one that you see here or number two. The concept is, and I'm going to spend a little more time here compared to the other sections because this is very important. We've understood that people want to do one of, broadly speaking, four actions on mobile. Create something really quickly, new note, task, sketch, whatever. Go back to a note that they were working on, either on another device or in a previous session, or see their tasks or their agenda for the day. Of course, the first two, so creation and browsing of notes, is more important, relatively speaking, compared to tasks and calendar. And between creation and browsing, we've understood that people who want to create something on mobile, they often need to do it very, very quickly. Whereas if you're browsing something or if you're searching for something, you might allow it like one or two more taps, depending on the situation. But generally speaking, when you want to create something, maybe you're in the middle of a conversation, you need to take a note, or somebody is telling you their phone number, you need to write it down. You need it to be a fast action. We have this nice little navigation nav bar at the bottom. Create, notes, notebooks, tasks and calendar, and each button takes you to the relevant section. And the home page on number one is button grid, where you can just tap the big button that is relevant for you in that case. And in item number two, you have the same approach, but with the addition of the list of recent notes. So we are testing both. We are gathering feedback from you guys on both options, and we will soon decide which one we like the most and you like the most, and we will iterate on it based on your feedback. The cool thing is that this is much, much faster to load, especially. Next is native calendar event. The concept is we would like to allow people to create events inside their Evernote account, especially people that don't have or don't want to connect a Google Calendar account or a Outlook account. So yeah, basically you're soon going to be able to just hit new event in that section, and you will see a new event in your calendar that doesn't need to be linked to either Google Calendar or Outlook Calendar. And as usual, you will be reminded with notification. You will be able to create a new note starting from that, and it's going to appear in the calendar section on your desktop app or your mobile app. And then we have more robust tasks. This is a very big project. Currently, you have the task list on desktop that you can see overlaying your app when you click it. A lot of you guys were asking us to make it more powerful and to give it more real estate, plus to add some little features. So first of all, we are giving it a whole section. So now you see the whole tasks section there in the left. So you can now add a description to the task. So it's like, often I need to like add some context to a task, and I don't want the title to be five lines. And so you can just add all the context in the description rather than the title. And then you have priority. So we are adding the priority metadata, which just allows you to press if a task is low priority, medium priority, or high priority. Pretty easy to understand. A lot of people were asking for it, and I'm happy that we were able to build something like it. And I think we're going to be testing this fairly soon, like in the next month or so. And then we have something that is even more exploratory, which is a dedicated files section. So it was very interesting for me to understand that many of our customers want to use Evernote as a sort of file cabinet to store their most important files, like, I don't know, for instance, a PDF from your doctor or a receipt from a purchase that you've recently made that's important that you keep track of it. And so this is exactly what this section aims to do. We released something like this to some people to see how they interact with it, if they like it, to gather feedback. It's very limited, like you don't have the differentiation that you see here between media and docs, for instance. It's just a list with sorting and filtering. But it is a nice first step in order for us to study this use case and understand how it goes. And then we have some more foundational improvements. I'm not going to speak too much about this. We are going to share a blog post when this is out. But basically what you can expect is that we're still working on foundational stuff as we were last year. And one of the things that you can expect is a much, much faster metadata sync and more reliable metadata sync. So metadata means the note list gets updated much faster. The titles also get updated much faster. The shared with me notes also get updated much faster and in a more reliable way, which is also pretty important. All right, this is it. So again, we have cheated a little bit. This is not just what we did in March, but we wanted to take a moment to wrap everything up. And I'm really proud of the team for all the work that went into making this possible. And yeah, see you next month, I guess.